Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's take a look at the Purchases and Updates pages in the Mac App Store app. So the App Store app allows you to go and find new apps that you want to download, both free apps and apps you pay for. But there's some functions of it that deal with the apps that you've already bought. For instance, if you go to Purchases here, you'll see a list of all the apps that you've previously purchased, even if the purchase was free. And you can scroll through this list and there are buttons on the right. Now, if it says open, that means you already have that app installed and you can open it here without having to go find it. If you see something like install or download, it means that you've purchased this app before, so you're on record as owning it, but you haven't installed it on this Mac. Perhaps you've uninstalled it, perhaps you've gotten a new Mac, or maybe you've got multiple Macs like a laptop and a desktop and you've only installed it on one. Since you've purchased that app, you don't have to pay for it again. You can just use this install button. This also allows you to own more apps than you actually have on your Mac. For instance, you can purchase something you need to use once, then get rid of it to free up space, or perhaps you get a new Mac and you just don't bother to add it, and then later on you can then go to this purchases list, find it, and hit the install button. So your library of apps can be here and you don't have to install them on. It's the same thing, say, with music and books and such. You can make all those purchases. It doesn't mean you have to have them all on your machine. Now you can also control click on any of these to hide them. So if there's something, say, a game and you finish playing the game and you just don't want to see it in this list anymore for some reason, you can use that to hide it so it won't be there. Now another thing is when you go to these apps, so say I'm going to actually click here, it'll actually take me to the page for the apps in the App Store, and you can see it has an install button rather than a purchase button or download button if it's free for this app. So if I've hidden something, I still can go to its page on the App Store. I can still install it from there. I don't have to have it in that list to reinstall it. Now there's also this updates button here. And what this updates button will do is it'll show you updates that are pending, and you can use update to initiate that update or use update all. You can also use the more button and get more information about it. Now if I had previous updates here on this Mac, because I'm logged into a different user account, it's not showing me them, I can also read the release notes. Reading the release notes is important. A lot of times I get questions from people saying that something's changed in an app they've got, or something is new, or something's been removed. And a lot of times the explanation for that is in the release notes that you could find here by going to the updates page and reading what's there for each app. So a couple more things I want to point out. This update all button, if you click on the right side of it, you can choose to do something like try to install an app in an hour, tonight, or remind me tomorrow. So you have those extra functions. Also, if you go to the store menu here, you can jump to purchases and updates through there, but also you've got this check for unfinished downloads function. So this is useful if you've bought something and maybe it's a large download and you haven't finished installing it, and later on you want to complete that install and it doesn't seem to be doing it on its own. You can go to store, check for unfinished downloads to do that. And one last thing I want to point out is that there's some links along the bottom, and the frequently asked questions link has some interesting information about things. Like, for instance, you may not know that when you purchase an app on one computer, you can get it on all your computers for that same price. You don't have to buy it again if you own two Macs, for instance. And other things like the refund policy, things like that. So there's some interesting information here to read over to make yourself more familiar with how the Mac App Store works.